Good day, fellow investors. I hope you're well today, as today we'll discuss an investment strategy that can make you feel well for the rest of your life. That's a strategy that looks for investments that can double, quadruple, or even increase tenfold. Such investments are not discussed on billboards, so you have to have the right mindset. And we'll discuss three things you have to think about, and we'll discuss where to find them and how to look for them, how to look for such investments. And I'll also throw in a few stocks that I really believe can become multi-baggers. That's the term for stocks that can increase in value a few times. So a stock that quadruples is a 4-bagger, a stock that increases 10 times is a 10-bagger. Let's immediately start with the mindset, and that's crucial for this kind of investment strategy. If you have the right mindset to look for investments that offer huge potential, then you will find such investments. If you have a mindset that looks for mediocre, small returns, you will find small returns. The first thing to keep in mind when investing in multi-baggers is that you have to let the investment grow. I know a lot of people that invested in Amazon, the stock price increased 10% and they sold. They now regret, because if they wouldn't have sold, they would now be retired. So much did the price of Amazon increase. So really, when you set apart some money to look for such investments, please don't sell after a 10, 20, 50% increase in the stock price. Because if your first goal was to keep that stock until it doubles or increases 10 times, then you should keep it until that happens. If that happens and you sold at a very early stage, then you will regret it the rest of your life. The second thing to think about is that such investments that have huge potential are not in the eye of the public. Those are covered, those are under the radar, and you have to really look for such investments that have the potential to increase in the future, so you have to see beyond what the current investment environment sees. That doesn't mean that those investments have to be risky. That just means that they have to take advantage of trends, or you have to see things before other people see them. When all people see what's going on, then the price of such an investment will already be very, very high. Number three, very important, there is no guarantee that the investment will double, triple, or even more. So you have to really approach such investments with the mindset that I put that money in and I forget about that money. Because let's say you have some money and in 5 years you plan to buy a house. You will need for a down payment. And you say, okay, I'll sell those stocks and pay for the down payment. You buy something, it is flat for 5 years. There are many stocks that are that way. Flat for 5 years, you say, oh, that stock is going nowhere, you sell. Year six, it explodes 100 times. That's possible. So you really have to allocate the money that you're not going to need forever. And if you increase your investment 10, 20 times, 50 times, then you will use that money for luxury. Then you will buy a bigger house. But until that happens, you will be happy living the way you are living now. So you are not going to lose anything in your lifestyle if you invest in multi-baggers. This will allow you to wait. This will allow you to let the investment grow and take full advantage of the potential it has. And this will allow you not to sell at the wrong moment in time. Where to look for such investments? First, look for sectors that have huge growth potential, but the growth is not yet recognized by the markets. A perfect example of such a company is Tesla. 5 years ago, Tesla was just a small company and everybody was thinking, oh, those electric vehicles are never going to succeed. But those who saw the trend, those who saw the boom in electric vehicles and that invested in Tesla, have increased their money 10 times in the last 5 years. So we now have to look at investments at sectors that have the potential to explode, like Tesla and the electric car market did in the last 5 years. One sector that's very, very interesting is the 5G telecommunication technology. The world today is all about data. It's not yet recognized by the market. The stock that has the technology is Qualcomm. It's very cheap in relation to other stocks now, so that might be a potential multi-bagger stock in the next 5-10 years as the technology takes over. However, you have to have the courage to invest now when nobody thinks about 5G yet. But when that happens, the potential is huge. And in the links below, you have the analysis of the stocks that I think can really become multi-baggers in the future. So later, check the description below. And of course, on this channel, I'll be analyzing plenty more investments that have the potential to really explode in the next 2, 5, 10 years. So if you're interested in such investments, and what I do is look at low risk investments, so where you can't lose much, then please consider subscribing. Another sector that's expected to boom are sectors related to the electric vehicle industry. So we know Tesla is going to need nickel for making their batteries. We know there is going to be a huge demand for copper because cars need more copper, electric cars. You need to connect, you need to make the chargers, renewable energy and all those kind of things. All those have one metal in common, that's copper, for all the energy distribution that will be needed in the future. So very interesting to look how will that evolve. The second place where to look for multi-bagger investments is there where there is blood on the streets. There where nobody wants to go because the sector is terrible. One sector that is in such a state now is retail. So you might want to look there for really gems if you understand the sector. If not, you can wait for other sectors. There are constantly new sectors in trouble. And if you buy at the lows, and if you manage to find a company that's valuable, that's not affected by what's going on in the sector, you can expect the stock to increase many times in the next few years as the company keeps growing earnings and the sector recovers. An example of such a sector in the last 2 years have been commodities. In January 2016, nobody wanted to come close to commodities, let's say copper. Now it's booming, but 2 years ago nobody wanted it. If you invested then in companies that have huge production, that were selling copper, then you could have tripled your money in a few months. And if you look at such scenarios, you can always find those sectors with negative sentiment, look at valuable companies, and then invest with a margin of safety. An example here, Freeport-McMoRan, a copper miner, has tripled since the January 2016 lows. However, you had to have the courage to invest in a stock that has been nothing but going down for the past 3 years. Keep looking at this channel. We constantly discuss how to find companies with a margin of safety, what's the actual value of the company despite economic cycles. A video is coming out where we discuss how to determine the value, the margin of safety of a stock, and such strategies really help in determining where's the bottom for a stock or a sector, like in this case, the commodities sector. A company that we have discussed here that is still in a low place from the sector because nickel prices are very low is Norilsk Nickel. Again, the link is in the description below. So when nickel prices recover, the stock will double or even triple. Another place where to look for multi-baggers are emerging markets. Those markets are very, very volatile, which means that there are lots of opportunities, but general investment community considers them risky. However, people still have to eat in emerging markets, people still use electricity, people still use the internet, and will be doing more of that. So there is a margin of safety, and if you find cheap investments that have a lot of potential, then you can really, really find good investments and have great returns. One investment that we discussed in emerging markets is Yupai Holdings, a wealth management company that has huge growth and a very low valuation. So feel free to look at that video. The link is again in the description below. Just to look at the Chinese stock market in the last few years. In 2015, it peaked at above 5,000 points, then it crashed to below 3,000, and it's slowly recovering. However, the Chinese economy continued growing in the meantime, so the Chinese stock market is really cheap. As soon as there will be again positive news, as soon as people will again dare to invest there, you can expect another boom to 5,000 or even 10,000 somewhere in the next year, 2, 5, 10. So that's again a potential multi-bagger. Finding companies like UPI will exponentially increase that potential. The third way where to look for multi-baggers is taking advantage of black swans. A black swan is a risk that attacks the financial market, but nobody expects. In 2007, nobody expected a financial crisis in the next 2 years. But those who bought options, let's say put options, expecting that crisis, those made a lot of money. And in 2007, when nobody expected something like that, then those put options were very, very cheap. And if you want to create such a strategy where you invest in black swans, very long tail risks, so that can really bring to extreme returns. So that's options. Another black swan investment is gold and gold miners. I have put up here the chart of Gold Corp since 2000, and you can see that the price of the stock was at $3 in 2000. It went up to 55 in 2011, so that's a 15-fold increase. And now it dropped again to 12 as the economy improved. If gold prices increase again in the next year, 5 years, due to central banks printing more money or economic crisis, you can expect Gold Corp to again increase 10 to 15 times. So this is not a put option, or you can call it a put option with no expiration date, which is the best investment out there. I haven't yet analyzed Gold Corp as a company. There are many other miners that I have analyzed. You have the links below, but I will be analyzing Gold Corp. So to conclude, we really should all look for multi-baggers. You don't have to allocate the whole portfolio to that. Perhaps if you're young, if you have only a few thousands to invest, you really could put all that money into companies that have the potential to become 10 baggers. Because if you lose everything, oh, it's just a little bit of money. However, if you make it, then it's really a significant thing for your life. If you're older, you can allocate 90% to stable investments that give you capital protection and just 10% to multi-baggers. If those really evolve as planned and you increase 10 times the few investments you planned as multi-baggers, then you can really treat yourself with something luxurious. The good thing today is that the world is changing extremely fast. We cannot keep up with how fast the world is changing, and what we all like is stability. We don't even see the changes. As I mentioned, 5G, electric vehicles, oil is going down. Just 3 years ago, oil was at $100 and more per barrel. Now it's at 40, 50, and nobody is looking again that it could be at 100 again. So the world is changing, shifting very, very quickly, and there will be many, many more potential 5, 10, 20, 50, 100 beggars on the stock market and in other places. So keep your eyes open. We'll discuss a lot of potential multi-baggers, so consider subscribing. Thank you for watching. Leave your comments below, ideas, questions. I'm happy to communicate with you. Your comments give a lot of value to me also, from stock ideas, from feeling how the market thinks, so very, very important. I wish you all the best, and I'll see you in the next video.